morning, dear students. We have started with the topic, the proposal. I have already told you that Lumo had come to Chubuko's house to ask Natalia's hand in marriage. And then they start quarreling over their odds and meadows, isn't it? So, when Natalia and Lumo quarrels with each other, Chubuko also joins in the quarrel. And then they start calling names to each other. Now let's see what happens next. Lumo, my left foot has gone to sleep. You are an integer. Oh, my heart. And it's an open secret that believe the last elections you've read. I can see stars. Where is my hat? Now, Lumo complains that his foot is dumb. He calls Chubuko a plotter. He also says that he has pain in his heart. He also goes on continuing and talks about the last election in which Chubuko was, then he doesn't complete his sentence. He feels dizzy and he calls for his hat. Natalia, it's low, it's dishonest, it's mean. So when he behaves in this way, Natalia calls this act as dishonest, low and mean. Chubuko, and you are just a malicious, double-faced intriguer. Yes. Now, malicious means hateful or intending to do some harm. So, Chubuko calls Lumo as malicious, double-faced and intriguer. So, here Chubuko calls him with by different names. Lumo, here's my hat, my heart, which way? Where's the door? Oh, I think I'm dying. My foot's quite numb. Now, numb means deprived of physical sensation. Means there is no sensation in it. So that is deprived. Now, finally, Lumo finds his hat and he asks the direction towards the door as he wants to go out. So he has pain in his heart and also his foot is numb. Means he doesn't have any kind of sensation in his foot. Chubuko following him, and don't set foot in my house again. Now Chubuko is very angry at Lumo's behavior. And when he goes towards the door, Chubuko also follows him and he says that don't step again in my house, don't come in my house again. Natalia, take it to court, we'll see. So Natalia also tells Lumo that you take the matter of odds and meadows to the court. Now here she wants to say that she is not afraid of whatever Lumo does, or if he takes the matter to the court, she is not afraid at all. Chubuko, devil take him. So now Chubuko is so angry that he tells devil to take Lumo along with him. Natalia, what a rascal. What trust can one have in one's neighbors after that? So Natalia calls him rascal. Rascal means devil. Natalia also calls him a devil and says that nobody can trust such neighbor. Chubuko, the villain, the scarecrow. So now your Chubuko calls him by names. Natalia, the monster. First he takes our land and then he has the impudence to abuse us. Impudence means audacity. So Natalia says that first he demands he claims that the dogs and widows are his, and then and he also has the audacity to abuse us. So she feels that how can a person call their other's property as its own, and how can he dare to abuse them? Chubuko, and that blind hen, yes, that termy ghost has the confounded cheek to make a proposal and so on. What? A proposal? Now again here Chubuko calls him names and says that confounded means confused. So Chubuko starts cursing him, and while cursing he reveals the real reason behind Lumo's visit. He tells that he has visited there to ask for the proposal. He is surprised, he doesn't believe that he had come with this audacity to ask for the proposal. Natalia, what proposal? Chubuko, why? He came here to propose you. So now Natalia doesn't know anything about the proposal. So she asks what kind of proposal he had brought. At that time, Natalia's father Chubuko replies that he had come with the proposal to marry you. He has come to propose you. Natalia, to propose to me? Why didn't you tell me so before? So now Natalia is very much surprised. She is astonished. And she tells that if you had come to propose me, then why you have not told it earlier to me? She asks her father why he had not told it earlier to her. Chubuko, so he dresses up in the evening clothes, the stuffed sausage, the wizened-faced frump. Frump means an unattractive woman. So now he Chubuko further calls Lumo names, and he shows his displeasure, his dislike of Lumo coming in evening dress. Natalia, to propose to me? Ah, falls into an easy chair and wails. Bring him back, back. Ah, bring him here. Now Natalia is astonished at the news, and she falls into the armchair and tells her father to call Lumo back. Chubuko, bring whom here? Now Chubuko doesn't really understand whom Natalia is talking about. He is not very sure who she is referring to, and so she so Chubuko asks her again whom to bring. Natalia, quick, quick, I'm ill, fetch him. So Natalia again tells her father that she is feeling ill, so call him back. Chubuko, what's that? What's the matter with you? Clutches at his head. Oh, unhappy man that I am. I'll shoot myself, I'll hang myself. We have done for her. Now Chubuko doesn't understand Natalia's behavior, and so he feels that he is a very unhappy man. Because he doesn't understand Natalia's behavior. Earlier she had a quarrel with Lumo, and now she wants Chubuko to call him back. So he doesn't understand this behavior of Natalia. So he feels that he is unhappy man. So he feels as if to shoot himself or to hang himself. Natalia, I'm dying, fetch him. So Natalia again tells his father to fetch him. Chubuko, at once, don't yell. So now Chubuko tells Natalia not to shout, and then he runs out to call Lumo. Natalia Stepanovna wails, and what have they done to me? Fetch him back, fetch him. So now Natalia, she cries. So Natalia asks her father to hurry up and call Lumov. Poor Chubuko runs in. He is coming, and so on. Devil take him. Oh, talk to him yourself. I don't want to. Now Chubuko comes back again and he says that Lumov is coming. And so he says to Natalia that now you talk. You yourself talk to him, you handle him. Natalia wails, fetch him. Chubuko yells, he is coming, I tell you. Oh, what a burden, Lord, to be the father of grown-up daughter. I'll cut my throat, I will indeed. We cursed him, abused him, drove him out, and it's all you. So again Natalia cries to call Lumov. Then father angrily says that he is coming, and he feels that it is a burden to be the father of a grown-up girl. Now he feels that he should cut off his throat because he had behaved very rudely with Lumov. He had called him names, he had asked him to leave his house. And now again he had to call him back, so he feels that he should cut his throat. Natalia, no, it was you. So he blames Natalia for all this, but Natalia says that she is not to be blamed, it was you. Chubuko, I tell you, it's not my fault. Lumov appears at the door. Now he talk to him yourself. So Chubuko says that it wasn't my fault. Till then, Lumov appears at the door, and Chubuko tells Natalia to talk to him, and he leaves from there. Lumov enters exhausted. My heart is palpitating awfully. My foot's gone to sleep. There's something that keeps pulling in my side. Now when Lumov comes back, he is very much exhausted. His heart is palpitating. He also doesn't have any kind of sensation in his foot. And also he feels pull in his one side. Natalia, forgive us, Ivan Vasilevich, we were all a little heated. I remember now, oxen widows really are yours. So when Lumov enters again, Natalia asks for forgiveness, and she says that they were very much heated, they were angry, and so they behaved in that manner. And also she tells that she remembers the oxen widows were Lumov's. Lumov, my heart's beating awfully. My nose, my eyebrows are both twitching. Now, he also starts talking about the widows, but he could not because his heart was palpitating and he had a twitch in his eyebrows. Natalia, the widows are yours. Yes, yours. Do sit down. They said we were wrong. So Natalia tells Lumov that obviously the widows are yours. We were wrong to tell it us. Now they are yours. So now please calm down and sit down. She tells Lumov to calm down. Lumov, I did it on principle. My land is worth little to me, but the principle. So now in that situation also, Lumov tries to talk about the widows. He says that he was fair enough and he was on his principle. Natalia, yes, the principle, just so. Now let's talk of something else. So Natalia says that yes, it was all about your principle. You are not wrong, we were wrong. So she tries to calm him down and she asks him to change the topic, because now she wants that he should talk about their proposal. The more so as I have evidence. My aunt's grandmother gave the land to your father's grandfather's peasants. But Lumo doesn't stop the topic. He goes on saying and he tells about the evidence which shows that his aunt's grandmother gave those meadows to his father's grandfather's peasants. Natala, yes, yes, let that pass. Aside, I wish I knew how to get him started. Aloud, are you going to start shooting soon? So now Natalia says that yes, I agree with you. Let it be now. Let's not talk about it. And now she knew how to change the topic. So she asked him about his shooting. Lumo, I'm thinking of having a go at the black cock. Honored Natalia Stepanovna, after the harvest. Oh, have you heard? Just think what a misfortune I have had. My dog, guess who you knew, has gone lame. Now lame means unable to walk without difficulty. One who has difficulty in walking, that is lame. Now as he is asked about his plans for shooting, Lumos shares his plan about shooting. He plans to go to Black Cock after harvest. He also tells her that his dog Guess has difficulty in walking. Natalia, what a pity. Why? Natalia shows her sympathy and asks the reason how his dog has become lame. Lumo, I don't know, must have got his leg twisted or beaten by some other dog. Sighs, my very best dog, to say nothing of the expense. I gave Mirono 125 rubles for him. Now Lumo is not sure about the reason of his dog being lame. So he supposes or he assumes that maybe his leg has twisted or some other dog has beaten it. Then he tells that his dog is the best dog and he had paid 125 rubles for it. Rubles is a Russian currency. Natalia, it was too much, Ivan Vasilevich. So Natalia says that 125 rubles is much for his dog. Lumo, I think it was very cheap. He is a first-rate dog. So Lumo feels that 125 rubles was a very low amount for a first-grade dog like Guess. Natalia, Papa gave 85 rubles for his squeezer and squeezer is heaps better than Guess. So now Natalia talks about their dog, that is Squeezer, and she tells that her father has given only 85 rubles for the squeezer, and according to her, Squeezer was much more better than Guess. Squeezer better than Guess? What an idea. Love. Squeezer better than Guess. So when Natalia says that Squeezer is better than Guess, at that time Lumo finds it funny that Natalia says that Squeezer is better than Guess. Natalia, of course he is better. Of course. Squeezer is young. He may develop a bit, but on points and pedigree, he is better than anything that even Volchensky has got. So now Natalia confidently says that Squeezer is better than Guess. any time, any day, Squeezer is better than Guess. And he is young and he may develop a bit. He is the best when it comes to points and pedigrees, and even beats what Volchansky has got. Lubo, excuse me, Natalia Stepanovna, but you forget that he is overshot, and an overshot always means the dog is a bad hunter. So Lumo disagrees with her and he says that Squeezer is overshot, and that means he is a bad hunter. Natalia, overshot? Is he? The first time I hear it. So Natalia disagrees with Lumo and she said that she had heard for the first time that somebody is calling him overshot. I assure you that his lower jaw is shorter than the upper. So now Lumo tries to prove himself. He says that Squeezer's lower jaw is shorter than the upper jaw. Natalia, have you measured? So now Natalia becomes angry and she asks if Lumo had measured her Squeezer's jaws. Lumo, yes, he is all right at following, of course, but if you want to get hold of anything. So now Lumo starts to give an explanation. He says that he is good at following, but when it comes to holding, he doesn't complete his sentence. Natalia, in the first place, asking Squeezer is a thoroughbred animal, the son of Harness and Chisels, while there is no getting at the pedigree of your dog at all. He is old and as ugly as a worn-out cab horse. Now, Natalia says that, first of all, the Squeezer is a thoroughbred animal who is the son of Harness and Chisel. And on the other hand, she says that Guess is old and ugly as a worn out cap horse. Lumo, he is old, but I wouldn't take 5 Squeezers for him. Why? How can you? Guess is a dog. As for Squeezer, well, it's too funny to argue. Anybody you like has a dog as good as Squeezer. You may find them under every bush. Almost 25 rubles would be a handsome price to pay for him. So Lumo says that even if he is old, he is far more better. Means in exchange, he can't even... if he has to exchange for 5 Squeezers also, then also it is not worth it. And he says that Squeezer is an ordinary dog which can be found under any bush, and 25 rubles would be sufficient for dogs like Squeezer. Natalia, there is some demon of contradiction in you today, Ivan Vasilievich. First, you pretend that the meadows are yours, now that Guess is better than Squeezer. I don't like people who don't say what they mean, because you know perfectly well that Squeezer is 100 times better than your silly Guess. Why do you want to say he isn't? So Natalia feels that there is something wrong with Lumo. Then she mentions that first he had pretended that the meadows were his, and now he is trying to say that Guess is better. But she feels that he doesn't want to say what it means, and she feels that Lumo knows that Squeezer is 100 times better than Guess, but he is not ready to accept it. So she doesn't like the people who feel something else and say something else. Lumo, Natalia Stepanovna, that you consider me either blind or a fool. You must realize that Squeezer is overshot. So Lumo says Natalia that she was considering him as a blind or foolish, and he asks her to realize that guess he was better than Squeezer because Squeezer was a overshot. Natalia, it's not true. Lumo, he is. Natalia, it's not true. Lumo, hush up, madam. So now they go on arguing with each other. They go on quarreling with each other. So now Lumo tells her, Natalia, not to raise her voice. Natalia, why talk rot? It's awful. It's time your guest was shot and you compare him with Squeezer. Natalia also doesn't like talking rot. So she feels that Lumo is talking rubbish and guest must be shot dead rather than being compared to Squeezer. Lumo, excuse me, I cannot continue this discussion. My heart is palpitating. So now Lumo says that he is unable to continue with the topic because his heart is palpitating very fast. Natalia, I have noticed that those hunters argue most who know least. Natalia keeps on arguing. She says that the hunters who argue the most, they know the least. They only just keep on arguing, but actually they don't know anything. Lumo, madam, please be silent. My heart is going to pieces. Shout, shut up. So Lumo again tells Natalia to be quiet as he is not feeling well. His heart is palpitating. So he tells her to shut up. Natalia, I shan't shut up until you acknowledge that Squeezer is 100 times better than your guess. So Natalia is not ready to keep quiet. She is not ready to stop the argument. She says that first you have to agree that Squeezer is 100 times better than guess. Lumo, 100 times worse. Be hanged to your Squeezer. His head, his eyes, shoulder. So Lumo says that Squeezer was 100 times worse than guess and he should be hanged. Natalia, there is no need to hang your silly guess. He is half dead already. So Natalia keeps on arguing and says that there is no need to hang guest because already he is half dead. Lumo weeps. Shut up, my heart's bursting. So Lumo again tells her to be quiet as he is not feeling well. Natalia, I shan't shut up. So Natalia, she is not ready to keep quiet. By the meantime, Chubuko enters the room. Chubuko, what's the matter now? Natalia, Papa, tell us truly, which is the better dog, our Squeezer or his guest? So when Chubuko finds Natalia and Lumo quarreling, he asks the matter that now what was the matter for their quarreling. At that time, Natalia asks her father to tell who was better dog, whether their Squeezer was better or Lumo's guess was better. Lumo, Stepan Stepanovich, I implore you to tell me just one thing. Is your Squeezer overshot or not? Yes or no? So now Lumo asks him the direct question. He asks whether the Squeezer is overshot or not. Chubuko, and suppose he is, what does it matter? He is the best dog in the district for all that and so on. So Chubuko replies that it doesn't matter whether Squeezer is overshot or not. He further adds that Squeezer is the best dog in the whole district. Lumo, but isn't my guess better? Really now? Then he asks that isn't his dog guess better than Squeezer? Chubuko, don't excite yourself, my precious one. Allow me. Your guess certainly has his good points. He is purebred, firm on his feet, has well sprung ribs and all that. But my dear man, if you want to know the truth, that dog has two defects. He's old and he's short in the muzzle. Now Chukuko tells Lumo not to be excited, and he keeps on talking. He tells that at certain points Guess is good, but he has some defects. First of all, he is old, and the second thing was that he was short in the muzzle prevent from speaking. Lumo: excuse me, my heart, let's take the facts. You will remember that on the Marosinski hunt, my guest ran neck and neck with the court's dog, with the count's dog, while your squeezer was left a whole verse behind. Now Lumo interrupts in middle, and he reminds Chubuko about the competition against the count's dog, and he says that Guess was gave neck to neck competition to count's dog. On the other hand, the squeezer was far behind. Worst means it is a Russian measure of length. Chubuko: he got left behind because the count's whipper in hit him with his whip. So now Chubuko gives the reason why a squeezer was left behind. He says that the count's whipper in hit squeezer, and because of that whip, squeezer was left behind. Lumo: and with good reason. The dogs are running after a fox when squeezer goes and starts worrying a sheep. Now again Lumo tries to give a reason, that he says that the dog were running after the fox while squeezer was worrying the sheep instead of running after the fox. Chubuko: it's not true, my dear fellow. I am very liable to lose my temper, and so just because of that, let's stop arguing. You started because everybody is always jealous of everybody else's dog. Yes, we are all like that. You too, sir, aren't blameless. You no sooner begin with this, that and the other and all that, I remember everything. So Chubuko tells Lumo that it was not true, and he says that he was very liable and he may lose his temper anytime, and so he asked Lumo to stop arguing. He also says that everyone is jealous of others' dogs, and Lumo was also jealous about Chubuko's dog, and he says that all are alike, nobody is different, all people are jealous of others' things. So he tells that you just now stop the argument, otherwise I'll lose the temper. Chubuko says that he remembers everything. Lumo: I remember too. So Lumo replies that he also remembers everything. Chubuko, teasing him: I remember too. What do you remember? So in a teasing tone, Chubuko repeats Lumo's sentence, I remember too, and he further asks what he remembers. Lumo: my heart, my foot's gone to sleep, I can't. Now Lumo is unable to speak, his heart is palpitating, his leg has become dumb. Natalia teasing: my heart, what sort of hunter are you? You ought to go and lie on the kitchen oven and catch black beetles, not to go after foxes, my heart. So now Natalia also teases by saying my heart, and she asks what kind of hunter he was, because always he keeps on telling my heart, my heart. So he was not strong enough to be a hunter, and she says that instead of running after the fox, it would be better to go and catch the beetles. Chubuko, yes, really. What sort of a hunter are you anyway? You ought to sit at home with your palpitations and not go tracking animals. You could go hunting, but you only go to argue with people and interfere with their dogs and so on. Let's change the subject in case I lose my temper. You are not a hunter at all anyway. Now, Chubuko also says that, yes, you are not a, what sort of hunter are you? So he says that instead of going on tracking the animals, it is better you sit at home with your palpitations. He's saying, I sit at home and do your job. Your job is to quarrel about the things like oxen, meadows and dogs. He further asks Lumo to change the topic before he loses his temper. Lumo, and are you a hunter? You only go hunting to get in with the count and to interview. Oh my heart, you are an integer. So Lumo also tells Chubuko that he is also not a good hunter and he only just goes hunting to get with the count and he is an integer. Chubuko, what? I am an integer? Shut up. So Chubuko doesn't like Lumo calling him integer and he tells him to shut up. Lumo, integer. Chubuko, boy pop. Lumo, old ram, chisel. Chubuko, shut up or I will shoot you like a partridge, you fool. So now both of them call each other by names and then Chubuko tells Lumo to keep quiet, otherwise he would shoot him like a partridge. Partridge is a game bird. So he tells that he would shoot Lumo like a bird. Lumo, everybody knows that. Oh my heart, your late wife used to beat you. My feet, temples, sparks, I fall. So now Lumo tells that he remembers, he knows it is known to everyone that Chubuko's late wife used to beat Chubuko and he keeps on talking about his ill condition, his heart, his feet and so on. Chubuko, and you are under the slipper of your housekeeper. So Chubuko tells Lumo that you are under the control of your housekeeper. Your housekeeper controls you. Lumo, there, my heart's burst, my shoulders come off. Where is my shoulder? I die. Falls into an armchair. A doctor. So now Lumo's heart starts beating fast. He doesn't have any kind of sensation in his foot. And suddenly he falls on the armchair and asks for doctor. He calls for doctor. Chubuko, boy, milk shop, fool, I'm sick. Drinks water, sick. Now Chubuko also feels sick and so he drinks water. Natalia, what sort of hunter are you? You can't even sit on a horse. To her father, Papa, what's the matter with him, Papa? Look, Papa, screams, Ivan Vasilevich, he is dead. Now Natalia also tells her that what kind of hunter are you? She also says that you are not able to sit on a horse. Then she asks her father to see what had happened to Lumo. She thinks, she presumes that Lumo is dead. Chubuko, I am sick, I can't breathe air. Chubuko says that he is sick and he is not able to breathe. Natalia, he is dead, pulls Lumo's sleeve. Ivan Vasilevich, what have you done to me? He is dead, falls into an armchair. A doctor. So Natalia pulls Lumo's sleeve and she screams loudly that Lumo is dead. Chubuko, oh, what is it? What's the matter? Natalia wails, he's dead, dead. Now Chubuko asks what was the matter. So Natalia replies that he is dead. Chubuko, who is dead? Looks at Lumo. So he is, my word. Water. A doctor lifts a tumbler to Lumo's mouth. Drink this. No, he doesn't drink. It means he is dead and all that. I am the most unhappy of man. Why don't I put a bullet into my brain? Why haven't I cut my throat yet? What am I waiting for? Give me a knife. Give me a pistol. Lumo moves. He seems to be coming round. Drink some water. That's right. So Chubuko looks at Lumo and he finds him unconscious. And so he also feels that Lumo is dead. He tries to give some water to Lumo, but Lumo doesn't drink any water. And so Chubuko feels that Lumo is dead. So he feels that he should put a bullet into his brain or he should cut his throat. He blames himself for all these things. Lumo, I see stars, mist, where am I? Chubuko, hurry up and get married. Well, to the devil with you. She is willing. He puts Lumo's hand into his daughter's. She is willing and all that. I give you my blessing and so on. Only leave me in peace. So now Lumo becomes conscious and he drinks some water. Then he says that he could see some stars in front of his eyes and he is not able to guess where he is. So now when Chubuko sees that Lumo is alive, he immediately gives his daughter's hand in Lumo's hand and tells him to get married at that moment. And he also tells that she is ready to marry him. And Chubuko also gives blessings to both Lumo and Natalia. And he tells him that leave him in peace. Lumo getting up. Hey, what? To whom? Now Lumo doesn't understand everything. And he asks what? To whom to get married? Chubuko, she is willing. Well, kiss and be damned to you. Chubuko says that Natalia is ready to marry you. Natalia wails. He is alive. Yes, yes, I am willing. Now Natalia is also very happy to see Lumo alive and she says that she is ready to marry him. Chubuko, kiss each other. Lumo, eh, kiss whom? They kiss. Very nice. Two. Excuse me. What's it all about? Oh, now I understand. My heart stars. I am happy. Natalia Stepanovna kisses her hand. My foot's gone to sleep. Now Lumo understands that Natalia is ready to marry him. And now he is also very happy and both kiss each other. Natalia, I'm happy too. Chubuko, what a weight off my shoulders out. Natalia, but still you will admit now that guess is worse than squeezer. Better, Natalia, worse. Chubuko, well, that's a way to start your family bliss. Have some champagne. Lumo, he is better. Natalia, worse, worse, worse. Chubuko trying to shout her down. Champagne, champagne. Now, even after that, Natalia keeps on arguing about the dog. She says that her dog is good and Lumo says that her dog is worse and they start quarreling. Chubuko wants them to stop and so he tells to have champagne. I hope you have understood the lesson. Thank you.